It's the Daily Dog.
Hey, y'all. Welcome back to the Daily Dog. I am thankful that you're hanging out with us today as we continue on our Christmas week theme here at the Daily Dog. And y'all, it is a Tuesday, and today we are making that a Jethro Tull Tuesday. We're going to be looking at three tunes by Jethro Tull that are Christmas or solstice related. Today is the winter solstice. It is the 21st of December, the longest night of the year or the shortest day of the year, depending on if your cup is half empty or half full. But it is the solstice. And we were reminded by our good friend Steel Rat over on YouTube that Jethro Tull has a wonderful solstice song called Ring Out Solstice Bells to celebrate the winter solstice. And so that's the one that I want to start with. This song was originally from their album called Songs from the Wood. It was released in 1977, and the songs on this album are inspired by English sort of pagan folklore. So let's have a little happy Yule time, y'all, and listen to some Jethro Tull singing Ring Out Solstice Bells. Y'all ready? Here we go. I don't think I've ever heard this one, so this is a first listen for me. Winter is the glad song that you hear. Fun little riff in seven that they've got going on here. The little grows on the four chord, still growing on the four chord, and they make it back to F. F is the key that they're in. This is fun. Gotta get the hand claps. The happiest solstice song I think I've ever come across. At the exact time that they switched to minor. They went to the minor five, to C minor. And back to major one. Just as the silver planets run, seven maids move in seven time. Huh. Sing the song the bells call, wild, loudly chiming. I don't know why I haven't heard this before. This is really, really wonderful. Huh. And it's just gonna fade out. Really cool. You know, normally we get these songs that are written on or to commemorate the solstice, at least from a northern hemisphere point of view, that are mournful and sad. It's like, woe is me, the nighttime is at its longest the whole year. And this is like, let's party, y'all. It's winter. It's the first day of winter. This is a pagan carol for an astronomical day. Ringing bells is a longtime tradition on the solstice, as we, you know, sort of cast our wishes for the new years, and then we affirm them with the ringing of these bells. And it's really a cool sound. So thanks, Steel Rat, for suggesting that to us. I'm looking in the second verse of this. Joined together 'neath the mistletoe by the holy oak whereon it grows, seven druids dance in seven time, sing the song the bells call, loudly chiming. As I read into this, this is not a usage of mistletoe as a romantic thing. It's not in a romantic context. It's a reference to the more ancient Celtic tradition or ritual of oak and mistletoe, they call it, where a druid priest would climb a tree, cut the plant from the tree, sacrifice two bulls, that's what it says, and create an elixir to cure infertility and fight off poisons. I don't think we should try that at home, y'all. But just like I talked about at the beginning of the day, this album is based on these English pagan folklore myths. And so this fits right into it. And wonderful that it's the solstice and we can celebrate with Jethro Tull a little bit. So that was one of their older ones from the 70s. What I did not know, my friends, is that Jethro Tull released an entire Christmas album in 2003. Gary on Facebook alerted me to this particular album, and we've had a lovely time spot checking all of these tunes on this album. It's a wonderful album. It would be their last album as Jethro Tull until the new upcoming album that's due to be out next year was announced. And so, as I read in, this album that was released in 2003 is a mix of new material and re-recordings of some of their previous arrangements. So we've picked two that we thought were really, you know, that sparked our interest, that we wanted to listen to in its entirety. So the first one that we're going to listen to is called Greensleeved, and this is arranged by Ian Anderson, and it's based on the late 16th century English folk song Greensleeves. And let's see what they've done with this, shall we? Let's listen. Greensleeved by Jethro Tull. Here we go. Oh, that's cool already. It shouldn't be glossed over. He is a fabulous flautist. E minor. And seven. It's a fun little lick. You hear those little things in the flute? Flutter tonguing. Whoa! Descending bass line for a vamp solo. Oh, they went to a new key. They went down to A minor for E. Same progression, new key again. There's moving this standard progression to different key areas. And they made it back to E. These asymmetrical meters also give us such a fun little dance-like flavor to these older tunes. What did they do there? Cool. I think they went to the relative major of where they had been. I have to listen to that one again. But in our spare time, because the other one that we'd like to listen to today on this Tull Christmas Tuesday, Solstice Tuesday as well, is We Five Kings. So this is from the same album, the Jethro Tull Christmas album released in 2003. And it is also arranged by Ian Anderson. It's based on We Three Kings, the Christmas carol that was originally titled Three Kings of Orient. And this one was written in 1857 by John Henry Hopkins and is one of the first widely popular Christmas carols that was written in America. So let's take a look and see what Jethro has done with this one. We Five Kings. I'm expecting it to have a meter and five. Or are they talking about just how many people are in the band? We shall find out. Here we go. Bass, clave. Sneaky. It isn't five. Minor for the main theme, and then the chorus, that's some cool flutter tonguing, goes to the relative major. Love that bass line that's kind of starts off on A, the minor five. Really is a lovely arrangement, isn't it? New material. This is new material that they've written to. Maybe it's a transitory spot. They're moving around to some different keys, y'all. This is very, very astute. Hang on a second. That was really cool. I need to go back to that a little bit. Let's move back. They go to A, and the bass line, from what I'm hearing, is just a natural minor scale. They start on the A, they go down to an E, and roll all the way back up to that A, and then it's just A up through B natural to the high E, and then back is a fun little motive. And then the bass is playing like they're in A minor. And then when the tune comes in, it switches and makes it like the minor dominant. And then it moves back to D. I'm going to start back there. Then it goes to D minor. Really cool. That's That's why I said sneaky at the very beginning. Rhythmically just really attacking that stuff. Makes it really effective. And it's left unfinished. I kind of want to hear the ending again. Back up a little bit, back up a little bit. Let's see. You're kind of going on A. So it just ends on the natural minor. That's what they did there. It's just really fantastic music making, is it not? Our friends from Jethro Tull coming in and doing us a solid one more time. This is so much fun, y'all. Going back and looking at some of these Christmas arrangements that I haven't yet heard. And so thank you to Gary and to Steel Rat for pointing us in the direction of Jethro Tull for some holiday music. Wonderful stuff today. I think we've got a great week. We've already started off with a great week, and we've got a lot more coming up. So I hope that you will stay with us. But for today, I think we're all set. So thanks for being with us, and we will see you next time on another edition of the Daily Dug.